Dr. Jacoby's patient is in the delivery room to deliver her third child. The infant is born in a precipitous delivery. The resuscitation team determines that the infant is born at 39 weeks. When delivered, the baby boy is flaccid and is not breathing or crying. You position, dry, and stimulate the infant. He still is not breathing, but you auscultate for a heartbeat and note that the heart rate is 56 beats per minute. 1. You know that a normal heart rate for a newly born baby is A. 60 beats per minute, B. 72 beats per minute, C. 80 beats per minute, D. At least 100 beats per minute. Correct answer, D. At least 100 beats per minute. You notice some acrocyanosis. The infant begins to have some gasping respirations. Another team member applies a pulse oximeter and a cardiac monitor. You reposition the infant and begin positive pressure ventilation using a TP's resuscitator. 2. When providing PPV, you know that the provider must deliver breaths at A. 10 to 20 per minute, B. 20 to 30 per minute, C. 30 to 40 per minute, D. 40 to 60 per minute. Correct answer, D. 40 to 60 breaths per minute is the appropriate rate for the newborn. You begin to bag the term infant at 40 to 60 breaths per minute with an oxygen concentration of 21%. As you provide PPV for 15 seconds, you instruct the team to do a quick assessment of the newborn. 3. The most significant finding of successful resuscitation of this infant is A. Decrease in cyanosis, B. Increase in heart rate, C. Increase in oxygen saturation, D. Increase in the movement of extremities. Correct answer, B. An increase in heart rate after 15 seconds of PPV is a good indication of the success of lung inflation. The team member doing the assessment announces that the chest is rising and the heart rate is still at 56 beats per minute. As the resuscitation team leader, you go through the Mr. SOPA interventions to improve ventilation and increase the heart rate. After an additional 15 seconds of PPV, the team reports that the infant's heart rate has not changed. 4. You know that the next intervention you must do is A. Apply a laryngeal mask, B. Increase the respiratory rate, C. Intubate the baby, D. Increase the PIP on the TPs. Correct answer, C. Intubate the baby. The fact that the heart rate has not increased is an ominous sign and indicates that the ventilation and oxygenation are not adequate. The infant is quickly moving towards full cardiac arrest. As you prepare for endotracheal tube insertion, you instruct the team to begin chest compressions. 5. The correct rate for chest compressions for an infant is A. 60 per minute, B. 90 per minute, C. 100 per minute, D. 120 per minute. Correct answer, B. Compressions should be started at 90 compressions per minute. As chest compressions and PPV continue, you intubate the infant and order the oxygen concentration to 100%. 6. After intubation, chest compression to ventilation ratio should be A. 2 to 1, B. 3 to 1, C. 4 to 1, D. 5 to 1. Correct answer, B. 3 to 1. The team must avoid giving chest compressions at the same time a PPV breath is delivered. It is helpful for the team member to do compressions by counting 1 and 2 and 3 and. At that point, the compressor stops doing compressions and says breathe. At that cue, the team member handling the ventilation should deliver one breath. 7. High-quality chest compressions on an infant include all of the following techniques except A. Compression depth should be half the anterior-posterior diameter of the infant's chest. B. Apply compressions to lower third of sternum below the nipple line. C. Each compression should take about 0.5 seconds. D. Allow full chest recoil between compressions. Correct answer, A. The compression depth should be one-third, not half, the anterior-posterior diameter of the infant's chest. The team is providing PPV with visible chest rise in coordination with the chest compressions. 8. Before reassessing the infant, the team should perform chest compressions and ventilations for A. 15 seconds, B. 30 seconds, C. 60 seconds, D. 90 seconds. Correct answer, C. Before interrupting CPR, the team should do coordinated compressions and ventilations for a full 60 seconds. At the end of 60 seconds, the team stops CPR and looks at the ECG monitor to determine the heart rate. The heart rate on the monitor is still 56 beats per minute. 9. At this point, the team should A. Stop compressions, B. Resume coordinated compressions and PPV, C. Continue PPV only, D. Do a full assessment of the infant. Correct answer, B. Resume coordinated compressions and PPV. This is only the first assessment since starting compressions, so lack of increase in heart rate should indicate that CPR must continue. After another 60 seconds of chest compressions, the team stops for a quick reassessment of the heart rate. The team notes that the infant's heart rate is now 80 beats per minute. 10. The best intervention now is to A. Stop compressions and increase PPV rate to 40 to 60 per minute. B. Stop compressions and PPV. C. Increase compression rate and continue PPV. D. The infant is stable, stop all interventions. Correct answer, A. Once the heart rate is greater than 60 per minute, the team should stop compressions and increase the PPV rate to 40 to 60 per minute. Although the infant is not stable, unless there is an underlying cardiac issue, respiratory intervention should be sufficient to maintain oxygen delivery to the organs. The team continues to monitor the infant and provide PPV until the heart rate is greater than 100 per minute. At that time, the team should begin post-resuscitation care.